Привет, and welcome to lesson 10 of my Russian language course. I'm your host, Dmitry Slomov, and today we shall talk once more about shopping. To be precise, about buying goods in a food store in Russia. Now, in a food store, most goods are usually placed on the shelves. One may easily walk around and choose whatever is needed. So, one does not need to talk that much until one arrives to the goods that need to be weighed. Like, for example, cheese. So, when we arrive to a cheese counter, we may see that there is a great many of different brands of cheese, and we may have difficulty to learn them all in foreign language. But the good news is that you may just point at something and say, I want this sort of cheese, or how much does this cost? So, in today's lesson, we shall learn to get around in these type of situations. Imagine Dave has arrived to a food store. He is filling his cart and finally he arrives to the cheese counter. He sees some nice sorts of cheese, and when his turn arrives, he asks the salesperson about prices. He would say, how much does this cheese cost? Or in Russian way, how much costs this cheese? How much or how many? Сколько? Costs – стоит. Cheese – сыр. This cheese – этот сыр. Этот сыр. The word for this – этот may change its ending according to the word that stands after it. The word сыр ends with a consonant, so the word этот ends with a consonant too. Этот сыр. You may also remember some more Russian words that end with a consonant. And so before them may come the word этот. Этот чай. Этот бутерброд. Этот творог. Этот кефир. Этот батон. Этот хлеб. Этот сахар. Этот шоколад. Этот сок. Now, in Russian, any object, not only persons or animals, have gender. An object may be either masculine or feminine or neuter. The words that end with a consonant are mostly masculine. Творог, кефир, чай, and so on are masculine. And they come with this word, этот. So Dave is pointing at a cheese, and he asks, сколько стоит этот сыр? And the salesperson answers, this, let's say, 95 rubles. Этот 95 рублей. And Dave wants to ask about another brand. And he points at the other cheese and says, and what about this? А этот? The salesperson wants to say, this cheese is at 84 rubles per kilogram. At, when you are asking about prices per kilogram, in Russian sounds pa, pa. One may pronounce it po or pa or something in between. The second word for at some price is za, za. But the word za is better used for the goods that do not need to be weighed and are sold in the whole units. So bread at 20 rubles for a unit. Хлеб за 20 рублей. Cheese at 50 rubles per kilogram. Сыр по 50 рублей. So the salesperson says, а этот по 84 рубля. And Dave points at the cheese that he has chosen and says in Russian way, to me, please, this. To me, мне. Мне. Please, пожалуйста. This, he is talking about cheese, сыр, masculine, этот. Мне, пожалуйста, этот. Мне, пожалуйста, этот. And the salesperson asks, how much would you want? Or in Russian way, to you, how much? The salesperson says it in a polite way. Remember, when talking between friends, to you would sound тебе. Тебе, But politely, formally, one says «вам», «вам». In Russian, «вам» means also «to many of you». You say to a group of persons «вам», or formally to one person. How much or how many? «Сколько». So, the salesperson asks Dave, «Вам сколько?» «Вам сколько?» And Dave says, «To me 200 grams, please». «Мне 200 грамм, пожалуйста». And the salesperson weighs the cheese and gives it to Dave and says, «Here you are, please». «Вот, пожалуйста». And Dave says, «Thanks». «Спасибо». Let's summarize. Сколько стоит этот сыр? Этот по 95 рублей. А этот? А этот по 84 рубля. Мне, пожалуйста, этот. Вам сколько? Мне 200 грамм, пожалуйста. Вот, пожалуйста. Спасибо. Now, Dave wants to buy sausage. In Russian, колбаса. The word колбаса ends with а, so it is a feminine word. The words ending with а are usually feminine, except for the obviously masculine words relating to people, like, for example, short form of male names, like Петя. We shall talk more about this issue when we encounter such words in our course. Anyway, the word колбаса is feminine, and this word for колбаса will sound это, это. This sausage, это колбаса. Or this sour cream, это сметана. Or this mineral water, это минералка. So, in a similar situation, Dave is pointing at some sausage, and he asks, сколько стоит эта колбаса? He is actually pointing at it. So he may use a pointing word «вот». And he better says «Сколько стоит вот эта колбаса?» «Сколько стоит вот эта колбаса?» And the salesperson wants to make sure. And she points to a sausage and asks back, like «This one? Вот это?» And Dave says «Yes, this, this». «Да, вот это, вот это». And the salesperson replies, and Dave wants to say he wants this sausage. So remember, we have learned that when one wanted something, for example, sour cream, the word sour cream, сметана, turned its ending from а to у and became сметану, because someone wanted it, like я буду сметану, or я буду минералку. The word колбаса changes in the same way. Я буду колбасу. The word «это» changes to, and it changes exactly the same way. Вот эта колбаса, я буду эту колбасу. Or я буду эту сметану. Or эту минералку. So Dave points and says, «To me, please, this sausage». He wants this sausage, so he says, «Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту колбасу». «Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту колбасу». Or he may even not say the word «колбасу», but while he means it, he would say «Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту». «Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту». Although the word «колбасу» does not stand right after the word «эту», but it is intended to be there. So it sounds «Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту». Колбасу, or минералку, or сметану, or any other word that ended originally with «а» and changed its ending to «у», because someone wanted it. So let's summarize. Сколько стоит вот эта колбаса? Вот это? Да, вот это, вот это. Это по 65 рублей. А вот это? Это по 92 рубля. Мне, пожалуйста, вот эту. Сколько вам? Мне 300 грамм. Вот, пожалуйста. Спасибо. Now, Dave may want to have a sausage that is placed somewhat remote from him. So he would want to ask for that sausage. That sausage in Russian, та колбаса. The that word for колбаса, сметана and минералка sounds та. Та. But for, let's say, cheese, that cheese would sound тот сыр. Or that творог, тот творог. See, the endings of the words этот and тот change in the same way. Now, Dave is actually pointing at things. So he uses a pointing word вот for closer objects, but for the remote objects, the pointing word sounds вон. Вон. Like when you are pointing at a more distant piece of sausage, and you say that sausage, in Russian it would sound вон та колбаса. Вон та колбаса. Or to me, that sausage. Мне вон ту колбасу. Вот это вон та. Or when someone wants it, вот эту вон ту. Or when it is masculine, вот этот вон тот. Masculine words do not change if someone wants them. So let's hear one more dialogue between Dave and the sausage salesperson.
Сколько стоит вот эта колбаса? Это по 65 рублей. А вон та? Та по 92 рубля. Мне, пожалуйста, вон ту.
Great. And finally Dave wants to buy some pastry.
Печенье.
Now, the words ending with «е» or with «о», like «молоко», have a neuter gender. And for them, the «this» word sounds «это», like «это молоко», «это печенье», «это варенье», «это». This is also a general pointing word «это». The neuter pointing word «это» and the feminine pointing word «это» may sound practically the same, but they are written differently, and they change differently too. Now, the word for coffee, «кофе», is an exception. It looks like neuter, but it is actually masculine. So we say «этот кофе», «этот кофе». It is masculine. Some poorly educated Russians may say «это кофе». But this is wrong. One should only say «этот кофе». And one more example for this with a neuter word «это пиво». «Это пиво». And it goes similarly with the word «that». The word «that» for neuter words sounds «то». «То молоко». «То печенье». «То варенье». То пиво. So, the dialogue between Dave and pastry salesperson will be like this.
Сколько стоит вот это печенье? Это по 42 рубля. А вон то? Вон то по 90 рублей. Вам сколько? Мне 800 грамм. Вот, пожалуйста. Спасибо.
Now, if you don't know the name of something, you may always call it this, это. In this case, it doesn't matter how the word ends in Russian. We don't know it. So it is just neuter, это. So, if Dave has forgotten how to say, for example, творог in Russian, he may just point at творог and ask the salesperson,
мне вот это, пожалуйста. Мне вот это, пожалуйста.
And if творог is placed somewhat remote from him, he says «мне вон то, пожалуйста».
«Мне вон то, пожалуйста».
And of course, Dave may ask any person «what's this?» or in Russian way something like «what is this like?» «What» in Russian «что?»
«Что?»
«This»
это, or вот это, if you are pointing at it.
You might also use the word for like this,
такое, такое,
just like that. This is the way we are saying it. So, what's this sounds,
что это такое? Что это такое?
Or, что вот это такое? And, when you are addressing yourself to a stranger, in English you may start with saying sorry, like, sorry, what's this? In Russian we say простите, простите. So, Dave takes a piece of packed творог and he asks somebody in a store,
простите, что вот это такое?
And the person says, это?
Это творог.
I'll repeat it once again.
Простите, что вот это такое?
Это творог. Very good. Very well done for today. And that's enough for this time. See you in the next lesson. Пока.